GIMP is good, Inkscape is okay, and Krita is but Blender is, oh yes! That is the theme song for now. The technique that we are going to follow today is called the two steps of art. First step is to analyze, and the last one is to do the thing. Obviously, the hardest part is the thing. After years of working with this technique, I improved it and ended up with a new technique called the three steps of art. Research, analyze, and do the thing. But it is how the steps were called in the past. Now the steps are steal, Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V, and do the rest. Today we are modeling a YouTube celebrity. You guessed it from the title, it's Oliver, age 24. He's a professional drawer, as I'm a professional modeler. We are professional artists. We should make an anime together. Okay then, let's start. First thing, as any other professional artist, we need a reference. Or many. As an artist once said, a good artist always steals. Or was it to know how to steal? Can't remember. In that case, do what you think. That's how I pass my exams. Now that we have a reference, or many, depending on the complexity of the object, or our not-so-big imagination, the next step is to analyze the object or the character in our case. Unfortunately, I could not find an image with the full body of Oliver, so we have to use our imagination. On average, a human being has 1.999999 and some couple of more nines until a 5 legs. But that is almost 2 legs. So we can assume he has 2. As you can see, Oliver is wearing a purple Batman suit. That is because he is not creative enough to make a unique hero power and the suit. We are not doing that right now. He also has a big open mouth and 2 eyes at a similar size. Here he is not using the special 3D technique for unknown reasons, where an eye should be bigger than the other. Maybe it is not used here because Oliver does not want to be recognized on the street. He is a celebrity after all. He also has 2 bad ears. I just found a half body drawing of Oliver, but still I don't have any ideas of his legs. Maybe he doesn't have any. That's why he hides them. He has a bat or a letter M on his chest and the same sign but mirrored on his belt. Also, his pants, gloves and mask have the same color. That's enough analysis for now. Let's do the thing. Now in Blender. You can see on the left corner what buttons I press and also if I use the mouse. I usually do. In 3D, any object is called a mesh. I know it sounds bad. So any mesh has 3 arrows, one blue, green and red. That is because it's called 3D. Each arrow for an axis. This is the object mode where you can create objects or move them around. By pressing tab, you get in the edit mode where you can, guess what, edit the object. But only the object that was selected in the object mode. From this cube, we are going to make the head, but the head is round, the cube is not. No worries, there is subdivide, but subdivide divides the selected face in 4. What we need is to subdivide smooth, that is, subdivide but smooth. Perfect. Add more subdivision to make the sphere more spherely. To make the sphere more head-like, we need to make it longer. Scale it and limit the scale to 1 axis, so it becomes longer or shorter. There are only 3 axes, X, Y and Z. When editing, you can limit the scale or rotation to only 2 axes. To do that, you need to be in orthographic mode. What is that? Don't ask me! The shortcut is number 5. Use this mode only with the sides, front, back, up and down. Those are other shortcuts. When you are not using sides, get out of orthographic mode. The object doesn't look good. Next step is to do the bad fake ears. When modeling, you use basic shapes like squares or tubes. There's also a monkey head, but I don't know what you can do with the monkey head. Monkey stuff. The ears are a modified version of a sphere. By pressing Z, it allows you to have X-ray vision, to see through the object. This is useful when, in orthographic, you select a face, but it also selects a face that is behind the selected one. One click to selected faces. Let's double the fun. What is a face? A cube has 6 faces by default, but if you add subdivision, it has 6 faces multiplied by 4, that is 24 faces. And the good sphere has many, many, many faces. Also, in the world of 3D, we call faces poly for some reason. C is the shortcut for selecting many faces, easier than clicking on them. Just hold the mouse button and move the cursor over them. Top notch! X is to delete something, objects or faces, or other things. Many other things. R is for rotation, again. On orthographic, rotation is limited to only one axis. Very important is to cut faces that are never seen. That is because faces use memory and usually an object has hundreds or thousands or even millions of faces. That's a lot of faces. To cut, you select the object in object mode and add a boolean modifier. Change to operation to difference and select the object that is made the cut to and apply. Easy as crossing a street in the night. Alright, and finally we are done with the ear. Now it's time to place it on the right place. Firstly, we get into the orthographic, the right orthographic perspective, which is the right orthographic, and now we rotate. Important to notice that on the orthographic mode, we can only rotate on one axis. That is quite useful, but that's the only usefulness to the orthographic. We duplicate the ear and now we place it right on the head. No, it's not quite right. We need to make the ear longer, but not with G. Not with G. We need to scale it up. Why I cannot scale it? Oh, that's why. Oh, yes. That's why. All right. Now I can scale it, right? Now we need to do the same thing with the other ear. Rotate it and place it on the head. We also need to make it longer. Just the right. one head and two ears. That's very, very good. Now the next thing is to cut the place where the ear meet the head. That is because it's a good idea to delete, to erase faces that are not visible, so that they are not rendered. Easy. And now we can see there is a hole in the head, in the shape of the ear. Impressive. Let's do that again for the other ear now. We select the object we want to cut from, add a modifier called boolean. We make operation to difference, select the other object and apply. And we move the ear to check if it's the right operation. And it is. There's a hole in the head. Nice. Now we select the ears and the head and we press Ctrl G. That is to make one object from three objects. And now let's color the object. Oliver has a purple that is right. Something like that, but darker. That seems right. Maybe a little more. Okay, now we need to separate the colors. The face has many colors, not only just the mask. I'm also thinking of changing the shape of his head to look less like a sphere and more like a head. Nice. Okay, now we select the part that it's not on the mask and we need to make it smaller or bigger. I think it should be smaller and just like that to emphasize that the mask is above his head. Looks nice. And also we need to change the color to not be the color of a mask. But firstly, we need to make that... We need to add another material, create a new one, and then we assign it. And now we change the color to skin color. Real 3D skin color, which is yellowish, orangish, red, or how I like to call it, skinnish. We can also make a saving of those specific
faces that were selected. In that case, we need to select them again. Maybe a little more reddish. No, yellowish something, orangish, whitish. Yes. That's more realistic than Mario 3D. Maybe scale it a little. Now we change the names. This is not required, but let's not waste some time naming the materials. Ah, perfect. More headishly like? Probably yes. To make a mesh seem more alive, you add color. You can add a color to all faces or just a specific face. And again, the color is called material for some reason. Ah, it's called material because it can be something else than a color, a texture. That's an image. We need to find a realistic purple Batman cape color to use here. The mask is on the face, and it is not the face. So to do that, we need to scale the mask part to make it bigger. By doing so, we add a realistic effect of realism. Now we do the eyes, the same way as the head, a cube subdivided into a sphere. The purple is another sphere, but a smaller one, and black as a color. Pretty interesting, because the pupil is a duplicate of the eye. We need to make it unique, so it doesn't use the eye color, which is realistic white. We select the eye and the pupil and duplicate them. We also make them smaller than the original to add a 3D effect, which is not needed because this is a 3D object. But anyway, we also name the objects in the scene so that we don't forget what we are doing. That is important.
Ah, okay. This time I'm being lazy. So let's hear some music.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
To make a mesh seem more alive, you add color. You can add a color to all faces or just a specific face. And again, the color is called material for some reason. Ah, it's called material because it can be something else than a color, a texture. That's an image. We need to find a realistic purple Batman cape color to use here. The mask is on the face, and it is not the face. So to do that, we need to scale the mask part, to make it bigger. By doing so, we add a realistic effect of realism. Now we do the eyes, the same way as the head, a cube subdivided into a sphere. The purple is another sphere, but a smaller one, and black as a color. Pretty interesting. Because the pupil is a duplicate of the eye, we need to make it unique, so it doesn't use the eye color, which is realistic white. We select the eye and the pupil and duplicate them. We also make them smaller than the original to add a 3D effect, which is not needed because this is a 3D object. But anyway, we also name the objects in the scene so that we don't forget what we are doing. That is important.
Thank you. Thank you. To the scene, we add a plane that emits light. But we can do that only in Cycles, not in Blender Renderer, which is faster but less visually impressive. And then we render to get an image to what we have done. This took a while to complete in Cycles. Here is the result. Pretty Oliver-ishly. Go and subscribe to his channel. It's OliverH24. Learn how to draw. Really good. Of the artist out. Ah, this is a good result. The character really looks realistic. Yes. Well, this tutorial wasn't like a tutorial because of the part where I inserted the music. But the next time I will probably talk a lot more. Alright then, see you next time.